Hello friends, today we will discuss change of entropy. I am Dr. S.B. Kolle, Department of Physics, Shivaji Arts, Commerce and Science College, Kannad, District Aurangabad. So friends, entropy first introduced by Clausius in 1854. Now entropy is defined as thermal property of working substance which remains constant during an adiabatic process. Entropy is measure of uncertainty or randomness. So friends, see following figure. A part, see in A part, the molecules of that system at 0 degree Kelvin are in orderly manner. Means entropy here. And see again in figure B. Temperature has been increased here. So due to this randomness increase, then figure A. So we can say in figure B, entropy is greater than of figure A. So friends, we will see change in entropy. Consider Carnot cycle bounded by same two adiabatic L and M and isothermals T1, T2, T3 shown in the diagram. See in the diagram ABCD and DCEF are Carnot reversible cycles. So take first cycle ABCD Carnot cycle. Here A to B is isothermal expansion, B to C is isothermal compression. Adiabatic compression, C to D is isothermal compression, D to A is adiabatic compression. So here see Q1 is heat absorbed from A to B by the working substance at constant temperature T1, and Q2 is amount of heat rejected to the thing at constant temperature T2. So efficiency of Carnot engine for this ABCD cycle, it is reversible cycle, so it is given by eta is equal to Q1 minus Q2 upon Q1 is equal to T1 minus T2 upon T1. So we can write 1 minus Q2 upon Q1 is equal to 1 minus T2 upon T1. So Q2 upon Q1 is equal to T2 upon T1. So Q1 upon T1 is equal to Q2 upon T2 equation first. So friends, for Carnot cycle DCEF, we have seen this is for Carnot cycle ABCD efficiency. So take Carnot cycle DCEF. Here from this figure you can see Q2 amount of heat is absorbed by the working substance from D to C, and Q3 amount of heat is ejected to sink for this E2F. So we can say Q2 upon T2 is equal to Q3 upon T3. Now friends, here Q2 amount of heat absorbed by the working substance at constant temperature T2, and Q3 is rejected heat to the sink at constant temperature T3. So Q2 upon T2 is equal to Q3 upon T3, equation second. So from equation first and second, we can write Q1 upon T1 is equal to Q2 upon T2 is equal to Q3 upon T3 is equal to constant. So Q upon T is constant. So if L and M two adiabatics are very close to each other, then also take del Q is very small quantity of heat absorbed at constant temperature T, then we can write del Q upon T is equal to constant. And del S is change in entropy between states represented by L and M. S means entropy, delta S is change in entropy. So del S is del Q upon T. So integration SA to SB dS is equal to integration A to B dQ upon T. Here SB minus SA means change in entropy between B and A points is equal to A to B integration B dQ upon T. So A to B integration del Q upon T dQ upon T is equal to integration SA to SB dS. Means change in entropy is function of thermodynamic coordinates of the system. Reference I used for preparation of this PowerPoint presentation. Thank you.